And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Oh, crackle, crackle, campers. It is The Bonfire on location.
Out in the city of angels, Los Angeles,
California. We were able to link up. I was out here on Oddball, and...
And I came to meet you.
And Dan Soder was out here on his TFN Cross America tour.
Yeah, Dan Soder tit fucks America. Smashing boobs together across this great nation.
Mush them up, says the t-shirt.
Entertainment Weekly has called it the most extravagant tit fuck tour of all time.
Four tour buses, 18 front loaders...
And then I got my nice my tit compressors that I can latch on.
You're also hawking your merch, like tit cuffs, tit just mush them together.
Yeah, you have a free hand to play around.
They should make a sex toy.
Okay.
That's like simulates tit fucking. By the way, we should probably say we're so out of the gates here. It's Bonfire. I'm Big J. Okerson. That handsome man is Dan Soder.
You talk too sweet about me.
While we are out here in L.A., our numbers remain the same, everybody. That number is 844-COMEDY-9, 844-COMEDY-9.
Or if you're not good with the number letter thing, 844-266-3399.
Because who's got the time to spell?
Lou, the internet greyhound, or bloodhound, not greyhound, we're racing him. The bloodhound is out in New York.
Thinhead Lou.
Austin Head Lou. Just doesn't give him the
chipping.
Chipping. Yeah. Old Lou, you can see his rib cage when he breathes. Whiskey.
Go get him, Lou. Go get him, Lou.
I'm going to get him. And then I think Jacob's probably in New York being nervous that we almost didn't show up in time.
Lou's going to come in the studio one day with a bird in his mouth and spit it in front of us. Like, did I do good?
He's just going to nudge it with his nose. Lou, why did you bring a dead bird into the studio?
That's bad, Lou.
And then Andy's just going to be staring at it like, you got to bleed it out before it turned into a trophy. It's going to rot.
They drew first blood, not me.
They drew first blood. Now, I've watched that movie. I downloaded it on my PlayStation 4. I've watched that movie 4 times just because I'm stoned at the end of the night.
You got to use double electricity just to even get it.
Yeah, I love it.
Can't just be TV. It has to be TV and the PS.
Yeah, I'm going to bleed out all the electricity. I'm raising that rent.
They're going to come in and change the meters on us.
I'm running a nightclub out of my house.
I hate this weather.
It's the worst.
It's nice to be at Opie's broom closet back in New York City.
Some guy tweeted it. He's like, how much does Opie hate you if you guys are in L.A.? He banned us to the heat, to the desert.
He said that other studio was still too close.
He's like, I can smell him. I can smell that big-headed asshole.
I know there's anger in that studio. No, we are out here. It is the weather. I hate this weather.
Everyone's it's desert weather.
But you know what's funny? I've gotten convinced in recent years to say, look, I'm not a big LA guy, but I do love the weather. The weather's great. And my last two times coming out here, it has been fucking miserable.
Yeah. I think we're both very similar in the fact that we're both like hoodies.
I'm a fall guy.
I love it. New York, I want your fall inside me.
I wish I could remember the Fall Guy song. That I remember the Fall Guy. It was the guy Lee Majors.
I don't know.
Was it Lee Majors at all?
Oh, Lou! Hey.
Lee Majors had the what was the Fall Guy song? Lou, bring up the Fall Guy song. It was him. Lee Majors sang the song.
A woman has been punched and fucked to this song.
Yeah, wait. When the chorus kicks in, it's a good country tune. The show was about a stuntman who, like, you know, solved problems. I guess I don't remember the.
This song is fantastic. This guy's.
I don't remember the actual like thing of the show. I'll
jump off a building, fall in love, and solve a murder.
You got to see him. He's great. He looks like he sings this song too.
Yeah, absolutely. I have a firm handshake and I always vote.
I've owned 3 denim shirts.
I don't believe in underwear. It's for Europeans and godless fags. What? Lee, you got a little political at the end.
Because you know what, Lee? The song's rolling, but we're going to cut it off and we're only going to do one verse.
Yeah, Lee, I think you got real weird there in the second verse.
Now keep those black kids off my lawn. Before I go out there and burn them,
I'm going to start my own army and fight the government.
Yeah, I'm the unknown stuntman.
And I want to fight my wife.
Oh, that's fucking fan.
I love that. I love when like dudes like that, like tough guys, are just like, I'm gonna do a country song. It's that crossover thing. We did it on Failed White Boy Wednesday that one time with all those actors that tried songs. But I think it's
God bless
like,
him though. But I don't know. Remember the show Renegade? I used to think that he was
Lorenzo Lamas.
I used to think. I believe it's a myth, but I did believe that Woody Harrelson sang the Cheers theme song, but I don't think he did.
Okay, I've heard that. I've also heard
it
the
does
myth
sound
that,
like.
I've him. Heard the myth that I don't know if it's true. Alan Thicke sang the Growing Pains theme.
Oh, that might be true.
If that's true, then all's like, forgiven you know, about
forget,
Robin Thicke.
You're like, I forget how it goes.
I gotta get other calls, but I'll pass it along.
I think you guys are wrong on both counts.
Okay, well, it sounds like you guys are in a fucking war triage. What's going on over there?
Hey, MASH, what's going on, Hawkeye? Everything all right?
You guys getting bombed out? What the fuck's going on in New York?
This is not a drill.
You just hear Andy. Oh, I got some A9, but I'll take all you cocksuckers out.
He puts a knife in his mouth and jumps off a roof.
Ah, they killed Jacob. All he wanted was some cheese. All he wanted was some cheese.
No, I can't even get a job. Fucking cars.
Fucking cars. Don't you understand? He can eat. He can control a board. Eat things to make a billy goat puke.
I'm going to find it, kill it, clean it, eat it.
And I'm the fall man.
I'm the unknown stunt man. I don't think it's like, I forget the Growing Pains theme. Like, how did it go?
Show me that smile.
Show me that smile. Show me that smile.
Show me
that. Young Kirk Cameron.
Wayne in North Carolina. You're saying that song was so good. Wayne, you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Hey, what's up, dude?
What's up, Wayne?
Hey, just letting you know, not only is Lee Majors a good singer, but he's a good ladies man, because if you remember, he was married to Farrah Fawcett after the Bonnie May years.
That's right.
Do you think
that was like the Farrah Fawcett poster years, too, right?
Yeah, the leaning over and smiling.
Heavy nip on that poster.
Do you think she heard that song and she was like, I got to get that dick?
That Farrah Fawcett poster was like well known.
Dude, everyone knows it.
Because you see nip.
Yeah. If you've ever jerked off,
I think it might have been the bonnet. I think it might have been the bionic dick that may have gotten her, but who knows?
Okay, I think I like to believe that she heard the lyrics of the song and she was like, "He's a good dude. He'll jump off a building and he'll love me with honor."
I always wanted to have sex with an unknown stuntman.
You guys just go through windows.
Dude, she's so hot.
Yeah, she was something.
R.I.P. She died on the same day as Michael Jackson.
I know, she totally got looked over.
June 25th, 2009.
How did she die again?
Like pancreatic cancer.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, I think.
It's like, fuck to death.
No.
She was split in half by.
It wasn't an erotic going. It was a very sad and medical one.
He got, yeah, they were married, huh?
How long were they married?
In her heyday.
Yeah.
Do you know, Wayne, how long they were married for?
Wayne, you seem to be the relationship expert on... Whoa, hey.
Wayne, how was the reception? How was the reception on the wedding?
Did they have cake? I feel like they're more pie people.
He was actually Lee Major's stuntman in the show about an unknown stuntman.
I took a lot of falls. He got pretty cocky around episode 8. It started making me jump, do some things that were just mean.
It was... Wow, good run. Nine years?
Yeah.
Not bad. And those were the good years, 73 to 82, man. She was still looking fine.
Good for you, Lee Majors. That's why you get to sing that song.
I'm the unknown, and I'm banging Farrah Fawcett, so I'm raised up 6 feet off the ground.
I'm balls deep in a Charlie's Angel.
Fuck you, guidance counselor.
Kay Jackson's in the corner, jilling off.
Jilling off. That's
my favorite term.
I've never heard that before.
You've never heard a girl jilling off with a jacking off?
No, really.
That's great.
Did you make that up?
No. You'll use it so much.
Now, absolutely. It's become a main part of my lexicon.
Jilling off in the corner?
Yeah. Just rubbing bean through a jean.
Bean through the jean?
The old bean through the jeans?
If you line up the stitching right on the right, but you poor.
I never get when those girls say they have clit piercings and it like They come all day. It's like, no, you don't. Number
just walk
one.
Walk around like,
ooga, 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 ooga. Hot dog on a stick, please.
I just imagine her buying something at Dwayne Reed. Like,
she's like, cum farts.
You done.
The 60-year-old black chick at Dwayne Reed. You done.
You done. Eddie.
Bitch, you nasty.
Are these bananas on sale? Bitch, why are you going up over here?
I always feel like every employee at a drugstore in New York, it seems like you woke them up to do their job. Oh, like you went God. In their house and like, hey, I want to buy this pack of gum.
Dude, that's the valet parking. People not giving a shit about their job. The valet parking guy here at Sirius LA is the worst ever. One of the worst service I've ever done.
I love him. He's like, leave the car right there.
There was nobody. There was one person in front of us.
I actually did his job when you pulled up, because I told you how it was going to go.
Yeah, and he sat there, and then the best part was we came back down with our validated tickets, so we don't have to pay for this nonsense. And when we go down there to pay him, he's not at the post at all, and he comes over with no sense. I go, man, this guy's terrible at his job. Yeah. He really takes his time, huh? And then he comes around the corner, and it's a 50-foot walk.
Yeah.
And he takes every second of it. I mean, mad swag. He was whistling, which was almost shows a lack of like.
He just walks up and puts his fingers under our nose.
That was the last lady that popped here. You guys are probably wondering why I'm so late, but here is why.
Smell.
I give the penis.
So, you want me to park your car,
or take you out back and blow your back out?
You ever get blasted off to a Los Lobos cassette tape? Los Lobos
rock and roll.
I like, you know, when you're in California or New York has this too. The only places in the entire country where you'll see billboard space devoted to like Latina Music Fest.
Oh, yeah. What's the
David
name?
Ortega something something.
Who's the name of the guy? His name is, he's the king of bachata.
The king of bachata?
Yeah. I was looking up what it was. It was the king of bachata. I was driving through the Bronx with my ex.
What this is that. Great finger blast music, by the way.
Sounds like a horse drinking out of a trough. Who's the king of bachata?
She got so
show cute. Your face. Who is the king of bachata?
Romeo.
Yes. Romeo something.
Romeo Santos. Yes. Oh, look at him. Jesus H. That guy is handsome.
Yeah, that's like LA and the Bronx are the only two places.
I like to dance with my feet in upper bulk. I find sweating to be a part of
Romeo Santos.
Can you play the bachata for us? No.
That is the king of bachata.
No.
Not yet.
Dan Chandler. Oh. Farrah Fawcett died of anal cancer, not pancreatic. Thanks, Robin Atlanta.
Can we? Well, in fairness, that's funnier.
Yeah, you're right. I should have gone butt cancer, dude. I'm sorry, Rob. Looks like the truth is always funnier.
And is it from too much anal sex? Is that just a guess? Jorge from Chicago.
Hey, how you doing? I know her proctologist. She said you used to get rammed in her ass.
You there?
I am.
Jorge, what's up, buddy?
No, you're not. You're not Roman Santos.
Romeo.
Sorry.
Damn he's got it. Nothing on me. Yeah, so Farrah Fawcett died of rectal cancer, which is from too much dirty anal sex. Not even the
that is
kind.
Not true. Don't talk about her that
what's
way.
What's the proof of that?
There's no proof.
Ask a doctor. Ask an anal doctor.
If there's an anal doctor out there, which I don't know if that's the actual working title.
Hello, Steve Ronson, anal doctor.
Anal doctor.
I hear I just talk about putting stuff in butts.
I'm a dick medic.
Oh, that's my partner at our medical practice.
He's got a bag full of tiny stretchers.
He's got little gauzes. I don't know if this dick's going to make it. It's got to be put in a butt immediately.
Too much anal sex. Is there any science on that at all that says there's the anal sex can cause cancer?
Georgie, I'm taking away your title as Prince of Bachata. That's how high you got, but now I have to.
How do gay bottoms not just like going, why has that not become like an AIDS scare, like rectal cancer from dirty butt fucking?
Because that's like an old, That's like a
an old wives' tale.
Yeah, that's
what it is. Apple a day keeps the doctor away, and too much dirty anal will give you butt cancer.
My mother, who grew up in Scandinavia, always used to say, "Too much dick in the butt, and you die."
Isn't that a shame when a chick that hot though, one of her fun holes just goes to fucking the tit, takes her out.
It's like Stallone getting trapped in that tunnel in Daylight.
All that talent buried.
All that talent
just buried.
With a golden retriever and a couple children actors that'll never make it out of the biz.
That's the hardest. Man, you can't go gracefully when your whole thing is known for being like sexy. Like, what's.
Yeah.
Madonna's hanging on by a thread for the fame. Do you know what I mean? Like, she gets. She's hanging on by a thread to like that. Crazy level celebrity. She's such an icon.
Yeah,
I mean, people will always go see her. But when I see her now, I just kind of know what Madonna looks like now because she's never left.
You forget Dick Tracy Madonna.
And then go back and just watch the Borderline video and be like, I remember. And I go, oh, that's right. When I was a kid, I thought she was like a fantasy woman.
She was one of the first people that it was like I felt grown up for jerking off to Madonna.
Lou, if you don't play the whole song, I'm going to walk off the show.
Not only that.
Because I got to do my favorite part is the end.
And if you don't play the whole thing, I'm going to catch this 10:30 p.m. red eye and slap you in the mouth when you wake up tomorrow morning.
You want to get mouth slapped, Lou? I've seen him do it.
I'll do it.
I've seen him travel cross country on a red eye just to slap a man for turning off borderline.
Some old lady sitting next to me on the plane.
Why are you doing in New York?
Oh, I got to go slap the taste out of this bitch ass's mouth for turning off borderline with Madonna.
He did?
Wow. Give him one for me.
Oh, man. There should be a visual to this show because we are just cooking ass right now.
Playing with my heart.
You're right. She's iconic now. But this was like...
Yeah, look at this video. She's just... Something else.
I like the thought.
Then she pulled off the Papa Don't Preach when she had all like, you know, knocked me up.
Oh, look at her.
Yeah.
Understand.
Yeah.
I thought I was going to be one of those black guys with a big dick behind her who gets a boner every once in a while.
I like that's where your dancers. Childhood brain went. I went like,
I was 7 years old. That was my 7th birthday. My father told me he wished he didn't have me, and then...
I just thought about black dick the entire time. She just kicks him in the dick. Wham! Just kicked that kid right in the chin.
Learn young, youngster.
Yeah.
I like I forget this time, though, where this made sense. Like, breakdancing kids.
It's the extras from the Beat It video.
Feels like I'm going to lose my mind.
Dude, that was my favorite karate kick to do when I was a kid. You know when you do, like, the half leg up like this?
Do you know in the Borderline video, the guy... Oh yeah, dragon.
Yeah, that was my favorite kick to do.
Like you demonstrated it in the studio.
Like this. Like,
you know her boyfriend in this.
I got a good one. I can still do it. I'm 32 and I can still do it. Yeah.
Just let me do one too.
No, okay, you gotta do it.
It's my thing. I wear these stupid long shorts. What if I just split them right now? It'd be great.
Oh my god, that'd be great. You got it?
Yeah.
Oh
your glasses.
And your glasses. Oh. One shot, clear out two glasses.
James is wrecking shit with our karate kicks. To Madonna, karate to Madonna.
Did I split my shorts everywhere?
No, you did.
We'll never know. The guy in this video...
He looks like the king of bachata.
Do you know... Well, at a time he was. Do you know he went on the B? Was Louie.
No.
Sitting in the lap. Sitting in the lap of luxury.
No.
Remember that one hit wonder?
Yeah.
Christine, look at his face. Pull that up? Look at his face. Yeah, you can pull the video up, but you better leave. Lou, if you turn off borderline... Oh, there. Thank you.
Yeah.
Lou, good dog. Lou, you're lucky I don't have a 4,000-mile arm. We talk big across the country. Go, Lou just beats the living shit out of us.
I don't make eye contact with him until 2016.
Hey, what's up, buddy? Louie, lap of luxury.
I mean, crazy. Ooh. I used to love that.
I think my part. Oh, no, go ahead.
Okay, cool. I was going to say, I like the jacket with the flowing shirt that shows a little bit of stomach. The 90s midriff.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that was late. That was the 80s, huh? Here we go. Keep pushing my love. Come on, baby. Come on, darling. Yeah.
You're listening
listening to Jay Okerson.
That
plays
da,
the classic. Jay Okerson does Madonna.
Now that's what I call music to have a doctor finger your butt to.
Is this Louie Louie?
Yeah, that's the dude.
Day one, huh?
Get dizzy.
This song sucked balls.
Yeah, this sounds like an intro to an 80s television show.
This guy went out of, his career went out, and he was wishing he was Lou Bega. A little bit of hugger.
Hey, man.
A little bit of
Man, that's that vest without a shirt. That guy's real confident.
Oh, I bet he was
the,
just
the Mario Van Peebles?
Oh, yeah.
The MVP?
I bet he was just crushing it hard, though.
Before AIDS had a name?
I mean, what a terrible song. The lyrics are always useless. Any kind of just dance music is soulless.
Fuck you. Listen to that.
Sorry, I'm taking it. Well, you know, I say that. I know all the words. Be who you want to be. Charge your father out. The guy says he's so handsome that people started fucking him for money.
No.
That's the song's lyrics. Sitting in lap. Sitting in lap. Sitting in lap. He says, temptation. He says,
oh, that girl's smoking.
He said, I started charging by the hour for my love power.
Oh.
Maybe he's talking about his music as love power.
Yeah.
I don't want to make this guy a male prostitute.
I think you should, even though he looks like he also trains in capoeira. The Brazilian dance.
Brazilian dance and karate.
Dance. We'll bring up only the strong. All the time. I'll always bring up.
Erday.
All day, Erday.
Do you remember the guy who was in it?
Yeah, of course. Turn that music up.
What's his name?
Oh, I don't know.
Only Mark DeCascos.
Oh, wow. You're like autistically good at recalling these.
Mark DeCascos.
Now, he can't socialize with Jay. He'll smash a hammer into your face. But he does know the entire cast of Only the Strong.
Last time Jay made a B actor, he bit his fucking nose off. Said he was a big fan, then bit his nose off.
Remember that lady in Connecticut with the chimp? It was like that.
Just wearing nuts. Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Wow. Michael in Kentucky.
I was thinking Bill Murray. And
Michael, what's up, buddy?
Not much. I was going to tell you guys that if you wanted to see a good titty shot of Farrah Fawcett in her later years, a movie with Richard Gere called The Women. She's in there, along with Helen Hunt.
Oh, wait, Helen Hunt gets naked?
Yeah.
Helen Hunt had a little thing for a while, but she had a, she always had, like, mom tits, Helen Hunt.
I love Helen Hunt.
Dr. T and the Women. Oh, yeah, that movie has, like, a full birth at the end. It's really weird.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's like they're, it looks like in the picture, like, they're wet. Like, they're, it's not a great shot.
It's through like, a fountain.
Yeah. Oh, it looks like they're naked in the bottom, too, yeah?
Yeah, totally naked.
But this is a little bit later. This wasn't like super hot.
Nah, that was not long before she died.
Oh, well, way to make it all creepy now.
I don't recall Jane Fonda ever being hot, but she was like a big deal.
Dude, yeah, I jerked off to a Fonda Fitness cassette.
I remember those Fonda Fitness, but I still felt like it was like a mom teaching moms how to do aerobics is how it looked to me.
Well, whatever.
Assume me, dude. I'm Olivia Newton-John, man.
Oh, okay.
Michael, thank you for the Jack material, bro.
Yeah, we're going to have to go watch that movie. That's what we got to do. Thanks for calling
in,
Michael.
My backlog. I got to jerk off to Carol Burnett's Bush. Start making up old
stuff. It's like when you start learning about blues and you got to go back. You're like, and I got to jerk off to the first I Am Loose.
That's not real.
That's not real at all. It's totally
Jane Fonda splitting gape like that?
Not a Hergold in the gun. Yeah.
Barbarella. Yeah, I was never into her. Now I just look at her as like that old lady. It was too much. Not in my time was she hot. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's all that. Like,
I don't like her for not supporting the Vietnam War.
I really, well, yeah, I don't know. She never struck me as like this amazing thing. Young Raquel Welch.
Unbelievable.
Phenomenal. Phenom.
Unbelievable. What's the other one? Sophia Loren.
Young Sophia Loren.
What?
Then she became my ex-mother-in-law.
Really?
Like, oh my God. My ex-mother looks like that. Like Sophia Loren.
Like grumpier old men Sophia Loren?
Yeah, no, she looked better.
Look Raquel at Raquel Welch.
Yeah, no
Jesus.
Shit.
Jesus.
Yeah,
she'd have like an Instagram page now. I mean, come on.
Yeah, it's good shit. And she had those, my favorite, man. She had those old-timey banana tits. They all had banana tits back in the day.
Do you want me to take off my bikini and show you my banana tits?
Well, hello, mister. Would you like to see my banana tits?
Would you like a bit of dose of potassium in your wiener?
Young Sophia Loren did some nudity, I believe.
No.
I'm look pretty
at
sure.
Those, look, wait, go to the picture three to the right. There's a tit-fucking man. There it is, right there. You're just on it.
Wait, no, no, no. Up. Yeah, right there.
Oh, she's mushing them for you, dude.
Is that her?
Yeah,
dude, that would be that would get me to go to fight war if it was like the 40s or 50s, 40s.
Yeah, now she looks like somebody who cleans banks overnight. There she is.
What? What?
Yeah, look at those big old bananas. Look at a little pouch stomach, so you know she's a get. So she's a gettable. Attainable.
You just take her out to a good meal. I mean, that is.
I usually don't talk to fat pigs like you, but
dude, that's.
How about Elizabeth Taylor? Was she something else? I think she has some young nudity, too. She must have been gorgeous in her time. Liza Minnelli was never hot. She always looked like a...
You hear that, dude. Liza?
So take that shit. You want to have a dance-off? I've been into a fucking musical. Oh, wow.
What?
Yeah, she
that's Photoshop.
Perfect nips.
That's not real.
What do you mean it's not real? Those are tips.
What?
Liz Naylor.
That's
not. That's fake. That's fake. It's all, it's got, you know, she's like, people like old Elizabeth Taylor face with some young nubile body. I think those ones where she's like wearing like an Arabi thing.
All right.
It's pretty nice. Nice.
We got to take a break, but when we come back, we're definitely going to keep looking at naked old ladies.
Oh, man. Really, though, if it's funny, if you look up Sophia Loren or Elizabeth Taylor nude, there's just pictures of a young girl sucking dick.
What? Like,
what is it? Yeah, just go up a little bit on this. On the Google, yeah, just like a girl's ass, someone just blowing a dude.
Yeah.
Like, how is that correlate? In someone's tagging of a picture, they go, hey, throw Elizabeth Taylor in there. That'll be hilarious.
Yeah. That'll grab a couple gets.
Yeah, there you go. She was, I do like that old glamour look when they're naked. That said, when we come back from break and people can discuss this, I'll say high, most overrated in that world of showstopper hot chicks,
yeah.
Marilyn Monroe.
Yeah, easily.
Never gave a
we'll
shit.
We'll talk about it when we get back. You're listening to The Bonfire.
And now back to The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
West Side Connection on The Bonfire.
Badam.
I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson.
Badam.
We're in Los Angeles, so we're doing West Coast Gangster Rap all day Monday.
Ooh. I'm joining a gang tonight.
Are you? <That's> official. I'd love to see you on Wednesday. You just
yo, Crenshaw Pyrus.
What's up, Mark-ass busters? I'm about to clap on you, dog.
Why is Soder talking like that?
No. Clap on you, dog. I don't think you understand right now, dog. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Before the... Oh! No, I'm so sorry.
My foot!
Oh, no. Before the break, we were talking about Sophia Loren, Elizabeth Taylor, Jane Fonda, all the old hot chicks. And then right before, you said Marilyn Monroe's overrated. And I completely agree with you.
I do. And then...
I'll go as far as to say this. Not only is Marilyn Monroe overrated, but girls that are too into Marilyn Monroe are crazy. That's a good indicator that a woman's crazy.
Or Betty Boop.
Yes. Or the color, too much color pink.
Christ.
My friend Dan Fellows used to say that.
Oh, there was a waitress.
I'm Ron Fellows. I don't know why I thought that.
There was a waitress who used to work in one of the comedy clubs in New York who I think really used to have like a weird... They're always tattooed, but like shittily.
Yeah.
John from South Carolina. Can I say one thing?
Yeah.
What I love about the call board is that I'm finding out I'm not bad at a state abbreviation.
You're awesome.
I'm pretty good at it.
Yeah, you're really good.
South Cackalack.
Yeah.
I'm feeling pretty good. John from South Carolina.
Hey,
what's
man,
up, buddy?
Doing,
you're on the
guys?
Bonfire.
Hey, dude.
What's doing well. Hey, and my question was, do you believe Scarlett Johansson's our modern-day Marilyn Monroe? Like, what's y'all opinion on that?
I'm going to say no, because I think she's significantly hotter.
Me
than...
Me too.
Did you ever see that ass picture of her?
Of Scarlett Johansson?
Oh, my Lord.
Yeah, when they leaked, oh, God.
Holy shit.
Oh, this was a leaked picture of her?
Yeah, but it was before all that fappening shit.
Do you remember
Christine, bring that
had,
up, Scarlett Johansson.
Do you remember when she had the magazine cover where she has like the sweater over her tits?
No.
It's so great. You don't remember that?
No, I don't
remember. She's like kind of holding it together. She's got a... She's that's
no no no
Photoshop.
go back a page here. You gotta go, there was an actual article that said like leaked 9 pictures. Yeah, right there. This, I mean, She's fucking hot.
No.
It's above. You got to flip the switch.
Not yet. I like how you're like, you just know how to do this.
We've done this. We've had to go through this a few times now.
Yeah, but I love that you like flip the switch. So these are.
Oh, yeah. Dude, she, and they're just like, they're not, nothing of them are like super graphic, by the way.
I think she's hot. Yeah.
She's smoking hot.
I like her voice too. That smoky deep voice.
Oh, yeah. No, she, I mean, like Avengers. She's,
I feel like I could bum a cam. I feel like I could bum a camel light off her after we bang.
She's, yeah. Now, who has gotten to the point where I don't give a shit about her anymore is that Charlize Theron. And she was at a time. And by the way, she's still a beautiful chick.
She's crazy hot.
But I just really, Devil's Advocate, when she did that thing and she throws the thing off, she's all scratched up and shit.
Yeah.
From Satan, just getting dicked down by Satan.
The devil dick.
I thought that was like, I thought she was amazing.
She did it for me in Monster. That's where I really got into her.
That's where we got into Christina Ricci. Christina Ricci pulled something off in that Dude! Black Snake Moan. I was taken, blown away.
They just put up a picture of her as the mom from Adam's Family, Morticia.
The mom?
She's dressed like Morticia.
Oh, that's so weird. She played the
Wednesday.
Fucking, yeah.
Yeah, dude, she is crazy hot now. I mean, she was in Black Snake Moan.
Yeah, super, super hot.
Oh, we're trying to find this picture of Scarlett Johansson naked.
Yeah. Well, John, so yeah, I think both our answer is no. She's not the modern-day Marilyn Monroe.
But, if you had to choose which one you would bang, would it be Scarlett or would it be Marilyn?
Scarlett. All day, every day.
Scarlett Johansson. Yeah, I was never that into Marilyn Monroe.
You know what it really was? Yeah, I never...
Okay. Yeah, here they go. Here's the Scarlett Johansson's. Yeah.
Dude. Yeah.
I mean, she's good. She's G to G, buddy. And if you can see, I don't know if you saw the little shadow in the picture.
Yeah, hi!
Looks like there's a little muff happening over there. There
oh,
it is.
Oh, boy.
And that's just great. That ass picture is great. Ah, and she has forehead acne. What's she?
Yes.
I always got to find the thing that makes her attainable.
Look at her smiling in bed. She looks like she's just having a good time. You know?
Yeah.
Good job to the guy that got these pictures.
I'd let her fart in my mouth.
Would you?
I'd ask her to.
Do it.
She's like, if you're in the fart in my mouth, it's totally cool. You could do it. She's like, I'm not in that at all. I goes,
can you please do it?
Would you do it?
Please?
Could you do it?
I'm going to act like you're an inhaler for my asthma.
Oh, we've, what?
What?
Eric from Omaha tells us. John, thank you so much for calling, buddy.
Yeah, man. You guys take care.
Thank you, brother, man. Eric from Omaha. Eric, what's up, my friend?
What's going on today,
You're on the bonfire. Doing good. Omaha.
Omaha.
I bet Omaha dudes really know where to find good internet porn.
Yeah. You beat off to survive. It's like the way Kenyans run.
It's how I get protein from my kin.
Yeah, yeah. You got to jerk off in Nebraska. It's like the same way Kenyans like, I have to run 26 miles to get water for my family.
You're compelled.
Yeah, I got to jerk off because it gets cold here.
What's up, buddy?
Hey, if you go to whizbangpop.com, there are vintage nude photos of Betty White when she was 21.
Okay.
And it's nice, right? I think I recall seeing these at one point. Yeah, pretty nice. Yeah. She was all right.
Yeah, she got a pretty nice ass on her.
Wow.
I love the way just he said that. Ass, yeah. Well, all right. That's Betty White?
Wow.
Go to more. I like that their poses, by the way, that's the thing you could tell because they're old. The poses are innocent.
God damn it. I wish, of all references, I'm blowing right now. What was the goddamn place that she always talked about on Golden Girls?
Oh,
back in somewhere?
Fuck! From the town she, where she was a farmer's daughter in Iowa.
Oh, God damn it.
Damn it, marijuana.
Oh, look at that, dude. That's not a bad, that is a solid ass.
Yeah, but all their poses are like, now you're going out the window. Now you're going to hold on to the curtain.
It's because,
you're saying hi to your favorite fella.
They also have the tan lines of awful 1950s bathing suits.
You got to take off your carpet suit and get naked for
one piece. Like,
yeah, exactly. The fucking made out of carpet. It's just wool. Yeah. That's like the same thing with, all their poses are like that.
But she's been famous. She's only been famous all of her unfuckable years.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
That's got to be a tough one. Yeah. Unless it's what keeps you levels you off. Because once you become unfuckable, you got the fame to kind of fuck somebody.
Yeah.
But does that work? Does that work?
Ah, and you're handing out flowers. Now you're at the beach. Now you're getting off the beach.
Does that work? Like, it doesn't, does it?
What?
At work at all, does it? I was going to say how, like, an old, kind of grizzled, rich guy can get a young chick, and she will eventually sort of actually get into him for, like, the security and find a way to actually almost feel like she's attracted to fucking them. Whereas Betty White, you couldn't find a young, handsome, good-looking, in-shape guy that wants to, like, literally be with Betty White. Yeah. You fucking bitch. Is that real? It's Scarlett Johansson? What a pig. And I mean that as a... If you're listening, which you're not, ScarJo, wow.
Oh,
what
dude.
A hot slob you are. I really, honest to God... Oh,
we just put up the picture of Scarlett Johansson in a sweater. What's the cover from, Christine? Did you find out what that's from? It's from a magazine cover, but I forget what it is.
H Christ.
But it is crazy hot.
What a good picture, man.
It's one of my favorite pictures.
Okay, I gave a shout out to the fact that our friend Amy Schumer.
Yeah.
And there was a picture in between one of the commercials on SNL the other day.
She's in the shirt and she's sitting over.
Yes.
Yep. Good job, Schumer.
That sweater, pulling that sweater down.
Yeah, you looked.
I told her last night that
you said it through your teeth.
I had to bring it up. Yeah, I was like, that one picture, you should get it. Get a different copy, though, because I ruined mine.
Hey, you got a pen for that 42-inch that I ruined because I ran into it with my wiener.
Just destroyed it.
Look. Yeah.
Okay. But here I'm saying, so let's go back to my question. Do you think that you could actually like you think that Betty White, she's the one a little more dick, can she get a muscular guy, a handsome young?
Yes, she could get one of those. Could I be that? No.
No, to actually get into it.
Yes, I bet there would be a guy that just is so into money and that kind of thing, like one of those party boys.
If there's any gigolos out there listening, I want to hear like a real, don't call with like a fucking made up, like a real guy who's like, yeah, this girl gave me money or, like, you know, helped me out, and I fucked some awful-looking chick. One of my favorite Jack vids I used to go to. Did you ever see the guy who films him fucking his landlord for the rent? And she's kind of like a weird, like, smoker's head. She's
like Kingpin?
Oh, yeah. Oh, but yes. It's
really
exactly,
knocked
it's,
something loose there, Tiger.
It's really that situation. What a great picture, Amy, huh? Look at that.
It's a great picture.
New
York
I mean, yeah. It's so like she's getting like gut punched.
Now that coffee's hot.
That's hot coffee. I mean, like, it's a great video though, because you really see the guy just like, he's gonna bang this chick. And
where is this? Is this, you can find this?
Christine, look up guy bangs landlord for rent.
Guy bangs his landlord.
Or fucks. Put in fucks. Let's be adults. It's okay here.
If you're listening to this, you have a paid subscription.
Yeah.
Or
my daughter listens to the replays. So.
Okay. Well, MILF fucks college boy. That's hilarious. These are just going to get in like, you're going to get now
might,
is like,
it might be it.
High end. You're just going to get high end porn.
By the way, what's great is I could tell you if it's the real thing.
Hamster X. Is this it?
This is it.
What?
It's great.
Look at this guy.
Not even necessarily a good looking dude. He's got a nice piece on him though. The guy's got a pig on him.
He looks like he plays club soccer.
Yeah, probably. He's also got a shitty apartment.
And he's also a guy that wears his sunglasses on his head. Oh, he's just getting naked.
He knows what she's coming over for. He moves his furniture, which consists of one dorm room chair.
Like he's about to do a handspring.
Taking off his shorts. Christine, let's skip ahead a little bit in this. I don't know if we need to see the whole saga.
This is hilarious, though.
Wait, but let's go. No. I want to see his piece first. I mean, come on.
Oh, she came out of the shower.
Oh, yeah. And he just like...
Oh, he's hugs
it's
her?
It's so funny, dude. And her body is so weird. And just like, he just does it.
Almost uncomfortable.
It's very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And the only way I can finish.
It's almost like he's trying to assist her. It doesn't look like it's like... erotic in any way. Yikes. Look at that guy.
Like, he's like, I still think you're beautiful. I mean, he fucks her on a twin size bed in what is essentially a studio.
I love his sideways lay down.
It looks like Fonzie's above the garage apartment.
Yeah. Why don't you sit down?
He does. And he gets naked, but he really hangs out with her. Most of this video is him hanging out with her.
Just talking.
And just being nice. Could you possibly, I don't know, could you do that?
Oh, fuck. How down and out am I?
I don't know.
I think I could.
I've gotten like I've gotten a beige or two from like a chicken. I was like,
yeah,
like some like weird like smoker's hack mom.
Oh, dude, Tucson one time.
Blew me in Playwright's bath, or
really
not Playwright's bath, but like their liquor storage room. I was hammered.
That's always what it is. I was working at the radio station in Tucson.
She's like, I had the best blowjobs.
That's always
like, brought me this thing. And like, I mean, literally, she was almost holding a cigarette while sitting and just fatly blowing me.
So she was like,
and then a Mexican guy walked in.
I'm going to blow you. And then I'm going to smoke this Newport, this Salem Light 100. And then tomorrow, I go back to Kentucky.
Is that where she was from?
No, I don't remember where she was from.
I had a lady, when I worked at the radio station, I met up with a lady, and I call her a lady because she was like 41. And I was
like, because you can't say I'm coming, ma'am.
ma'am.
Oh, give me your face, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Put your face in front of it, ma'am.
Oh, ma'am, you make me so. Dude, she told me that I was 20 at the time, and she had a 22-year-old son, and I was like, damn, this is weird.
Oh,
that was like that. Made
oh, I almost hooked up with an older chick, and then yeah, her kids were in the house, and they were like close to my age. I feel bad, Eric. You're still on the line, buddy. We looked at those pictures, buddy. Thank you. Just know I'm gonna be whacking off tonight, thinking of you and that.
Eric, thanks for the heads up, dude.
Good. Good call. Well, here's Jimmy. I want to hear how old Jimmy is. Jimmy, he's on the road, trucker.
I'm 34.
Oh.
34, and you say here you still think Jane Fonda is hot.
Come on, it's not, man. I grew up looking at her posters with my dad. Now I've seen her new show, like, Grace and Frankie.
Oh,
man,
yeah.
She's so banging it. Oh, my God.
You're into her all the way up to the modern era.
Oh, I'm talking, yeah, I'm a guy of the classics, like Cassandra Peterson. Oh,
man, that lady she was still good.
Who's Cassandra Peterson?
Just like an old.
You don't know who that is? Oh my God!
No, I mean I know like.
Isn't that Elvira?
Elvira. Oh, okay, yeah.
Oh,
I imagine him. It sounds like he's punching the fucking so the top of his roof.
If ever there was a fucking a place for
TFing, Elvira. No,
Elvira.
I remember the Bud Light ads. Oh, look at.
But
her.
You've never seen Elvira? She used to do like actual like. Penthouse style, like pussy out modeling. Ooh. I want to TF you.
Hell. Whoa.
Yeah, that's her right there. Down. No, no, no. Here. There's like actual like porn. Go down.
Oh, no, you got
there's it. Actual like porny pictures of her.
And this guy wrote a song about her.
Mistress of the Dirk. Yeah, nude. As we get, there we go.
Wow.
Yeah, she was something.
Amazing body.
No, I think Christine doesn't think that. Yeah, those redheads are her. That's her.
Really?
Yes.
Good yeah. for you, Elvira.
Yeah, she was nice, yeah?
Yeah. Wow.
Ooh. Cute and like girl next door-ish looking.
Yes.
Almost.
Okay.
Oh, she looks a little weird in the face.
Yeah, she looked like a diner waitress.
I got adult onset acne, but I'll still suck you off in the kitchen.
I look great naked, and when I'm throwing down a slice of cheesecake at 4:30 in the morning.
Top off this key lime pie.
Yeah, I...
But she is great, but Elvira now...
But Jimmy,
what does Elvira look like now?
Hold on, Jimmy, are you just into exclusively that era? Like, do you only like old school hot chicks?
You know, not really. I tried it. To me, it's like this newer generation. I props to these younger ladies. But, man, I'm not into the skanky holes, man. I'm a Hooters guy, not a Tilt-A-Kilt guy.
And okay.
Like,
all right. That's a good distinction to make in life.
I love the stuff that gives you the imagination that it's like, oh, that ruins it. Now I don't have to picture seeing her naked.
That's beautiful. I'll be honest with you. I'm envious of that. I'm too far gone.
Can I say this? I completely agree with him.
I agree with him, but I'm too far gone for it.
It's good. That's what you are in life. You're either a Hooters or a Tilted Kilt. You're either like a nice pantyhose.
I think they're the same.
Me too. No, a Tilted Kilt, they like.
No. I mean, I think it's like you're a Hooters. Or, you know, a place where the girls shoot, like, ping pong balls out of their sniz.
That's the degree.
In between.
It's all that.
None in between. Oh, yeah. Jane Mansfield. Yeah,
Jane Mansfield.
Look, Jimmy, I'm a fan of the classics, too, man. And I'll be honest with you. Because they're mostly, like, famous, or they got famous, or things like that, like, there's that element to it that makes it jerk-offable. But I mean, yeah, I don't know, man. Like, to say they're still currently hot, although we just looked at Elvira now, and I'd say beautiful.
Absolutely.
Beautiful woman still.
Hey, Elvira!
I mean, so beautiful. Christine, by the way, to give her some... We just keep going through all these different screens, and the guy's just giving the business to his landlord. I wish we had the audio.
Red stop due to the fifth.
She said, "She does just, you're good. With my help, you could be the best."
Cup your hand. I want to ash in it.
Oh, you get to see that sag ass. Yeah. Behind. I don't know why. I love it so much. But I don't.
And then you
stay in the moment of like the sexiness of as they get older. Jane Fonda now looks like an old fucking lady to me. But I want to give the kudos to Christine because we have Christine working here with us in L.A. And she is killing it.
Yeah.
On our Twitter, we should say.
At the Bonfire.
SXM. Christina's putting up everything, following along here.
That's Scarlett Johansson, picture of her in the sweater. I want to punch something. That's what it makes me feel like.
Just so you know out there, Radioland, Dan Soder's going to jerk off to the Bonfire's Twitter feed later.
Yeah. Guess what I'm going to be doing in the apartment that I'm staying at that belongs to Nate.
And Jimmy, if you're on the road, buddy, you want to slug one out to your favorite shit? Christine's literally made you a porno magazine of what
all you
got to
do is just scroll down with your left thumb and let your right thumb just take care of business.
Put a little spit on your right thumb.
I follow Elvira on Twitter, dude. I can get updates all through the day.
But we're telling you, though, to go to at the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, and you're going to see all
these pictures we keep putting out there.
We're making basically a jerk channel for you. We're like a Pandora station for you.
Is Elvira worth following on Twitter?
Oh yeah. She's got some interesting. You can kind of get back to that old school one. She got a few weeks ago. Batgirl from the '50s Batman TV show. She passed.
Yes.
Cut old school. It's like, you know, you go back to that Batgirl, you look her up, and god damn, what was she hiding underneath that costume? Oh my god! And she's just that old school. She takes it back to those back, and you know, I growing up and watching some of these old school movies with my dad, and I follow Elvira on Twitter, and she'll go, "Happy birthday, blah blah blah." And it's like, that name sounds familiar. I look it up, and like, oh, I remember such and such and that such and such show when I used to watch it with my dad, and it's like, oh damn.
I like that, like, you share a legacy of jerking off to Elvira with your dad the same way I shared the 49ers with my dad. Like, I just imagine he's just got, like, a bunch of Bud Light Elvira posters on his room, and he's just like, I mean, that's what me and my dad both jerked to.
I'm an old man. I'm going to give you my jacking glove.
I polished off one to Elvira in 1978.
1970, goddamn eight. Well, Jimmy,
it sounds like I'm singing in the song on the bottom.
Bobo, yeah. You're the Bowser of our show. Jimmy, thanks for calling, buddy.
Thanks,
I'm with
Jimmy.
You.
Hey, no problem.
I think you're a classy son of a bitch.
Yeah, you should host a YouTube show like Jimmy Plays the Classics.
Oh, Brett in Chicago bringing up one I completely forgot to talk about. What's up, Brett?
Hey, Susan Sarandon.
Susan Sarandon could still catch it.
No, not anymore.
Okay,
but you're saying Brett that still currently you're in.
Yeah.
How old are you, Brett?
Completely. How old am I? 44.
All right. Yeah. You know what?
Jay, come on.
It's not bad, but I'm telling you that body goes all old lady. But young Susan Sarandon,
it's unbelievable.
Something else.
Young Susan Sarandon.
Wow.
I mean, look at that.
Look at that split tit rib cagey action in between.
Oh, I'm getting my tit fuck dance on.
Everyone, he's TFing. He's TFing in the room again.
Oh, no.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh.
She was so, yeah, those big, goofy Kurt Metzger eyes.
Thank you.
Hey, everyone, thank you. Look at my tits. Thank you.
Elvira!
That's in your head the rest of
Elvira.
The day.
Elvira.
Susan Sarandon. Good call, Brett. Thanks, man.
Brett, you nailed it.
All right, thank you.
I'll be thinking of you later on. We slug it off to Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Yeah, when I throw on Bull Durham and just toss one off.
That'd be my first question to Meatloaf. Did you try to plow her out on the set?
Oh.
Because he was Meatloaf.
Well, he, Tim Robbins, they met filming Bull Durham. That's where they started dating.
But I mean, and she was hot in that too. Crazy. But that was after Rocky Horror.
Yeah, much after.
Meatloaf was in Rocky Horror with her. I wonder if Meatloaf tried to go. Oh, he was married. He's like a married guy.
I wonder if Tim Curry.
No, that annoying. Ugh, I hate it almost every role he plays.
Is he gay?
I don't know. I hate everything he does.
He didn't like.
Rooster and Annie.
Yeah.
And how fun was that when me and Dan went to go see. We went to go see the War on Drugs,
which was great.
Amazing.
Radio City Music Hall.
In Radio City, and but I've never been inside Radio City Music Hall before, and all I know of it is the movie Annie.
Yeah.
So I just, as I walked inside to go get the tickets for everybody, I just kept going. I was walking through the lobby, and there's all kinds of people who work there, and I just go doom 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 doom. We got Annie, but ding zap do, like dancing, doing like leg up kicks, like Broadway style. We got Annie, but ding zap doom 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 boom doom. I wish someone was behind me just playing stand up bass on a wheel.
Man, bing, boom, or just me walking behind you going boom boom boom.
Yeah. Oh, got Annie.
That was a great concert.
Concert was sick. We spent a nice little. We had a New York night together.
We did.
We went to a bar with a porn star, former porn star, porn legend.
Porn legend Lisa Ann went with us to
work. Now, here you go. Sal. Now, she's 43 years old.
Yeah.
And she still is crushing it.
Yeah.
On hot.
Yeah.
I mean, without a doubt.
Without a doubt.
Something else. Oh, wait, you boning up? You want to go take care of each other? We should probably take a break.
Well, seesaw?
Yeah.
Want to see something in the bathroom?
Hey, you want to dock off a little bit?
Yeah. How about we take this break, play some commercials for the folks, and then you just mash wieners.
Let's let our pee holes tongue kiss. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Big J. Okerson, Dan Soder, the Bonfire. We are live on a Monday.
In Los Angeles.
In Los Angeles.
Listening to West Coast Gangster Rap.
We're actually out here also doing At Midnight Together
on
Comedy Central Wednesday.
Airs Thursday.
Thursday.
We're doing it Wednesday.
Yes.
Tomorrow. And then it's airing.
Then they're going to edit it for content.
Cut us out. We're going to be with the hilarious Morgan Murphy.
Who is awesome.
Yeah, she's awesome.
She's hilarious.
We used to watch boxing with her when she lived in New York, and then she moved back to L.A. And
she just moved back?
No, she's been working on, she writes on Two Broke Girls. Yeah, she's been
there
for a
while. She came to town for a while.
Yeah, she comes and stays.
Maybe she subletted a place somewhere.
Yeah, she comes and stays for, like, I see her at the stand sometimes.
Yeah, me too. No, I like her. She's fun to talk to, and she's, like, really, really fucking hilarious. So, yeah, me, Dan, Morgan Murphy, on At Midnight, Comedy Central.
With Chris Hardwick.
I believe it's on At Midnight on Thursday.
Yeah.
It was at 11 o'clock for a while, but that was, like, a week-long promotion or something like that.
Yeah.
Was that the idea?
It's a fun show, man. I did it with Nate and Nikki Glaser.
Oh, yeah, one of my favorite Nate stories.
Dude.
Came from that.
God, it's on my Twitter somewhere, but Chris Hardwick made a joke, and Nikki and I laughed, and Nate just stood up at the, he just stared up at the lights, and he just looked like he completely checked out. And I was like, Nate, when you don't go, I was watching it with Nate. We were both on the show, and him, myself, and Graham K, another funny comic, were dying laughing watching it. Nate just not react to the joke. He's just like, I don't know.
Wait.
But now, you and Morgan Murphy, that's going to be a fun show, man.
And we're all going to get the jokes.
And everyone's going to laugh.
I don't know, man. Hardwick, you know, the Nerdist. Sometimes they try to get a little too smart to make me look dumb. You think they're trying to make me look stupid? Just get that bully mentality? Yeah. You think I'm dumb? You trying to throw big words at me? I'll knock everybody the fuck out.
Yeah, you want to breathe in toilet water? I'll shove your face in there.
He's bullying you because he gets bullied at home for being a retard.
Not being able to read properly. You said you didn't like, so someone called in Cameron in North Carolina. What's up, dude?
How's it going, guys?
Good, man.
Hey, Cam.
Yeah. Yeah, I was thinking, because she was kind of quintessentially the buxom one back in the day. She was a little thicker. And I think the equivalent of that would be, Christina Hendricks today. I mean, I think she's beautiful. And, yeah.
What? And now we have a picture of her up already here.
Mm-hmm. And I think she's gorgeous.
I do think she... What is she? Well, is she an actress?
Yeah, she's in Mad Men.
She's in Mad Men.
Oh, that's my thing. I never watched Mad Men.
Jeez, yeah. You know what? I don't know if she is. I guess you could. I could see why you would say she's our modern version of Marilyn Monroe, just because she's like, you know, thicker. But I mean,
she's hot, big titted, and she won't say anything if you smack her across the face because she's from Mad Men.
Because you know your lesson. No, that doesn't mean she lives by those. I mean, I'm pretty sure she's.
Now I'm gonna put a cigarette out on your back so you learn.
Now. You don't get any drugs during pregnancy.
Gee, mister, I just want to go.
You're going to have that baby natural in a bathtub. And I'm going to watch. I'm not going to be in the room. I'm going to be in the waiting room.
My baby's going to be born natural.
I'm going to be having three fingers of Glenn Lovett.
Look at those. Yeah, but I'll tell you what.
Those aren't real.
Go to that first picture. That's not. No, go to the first actual picture. That looks dumb.
That looks great.
No.
She looks like Shirley Manson with huge cans.
They start.
That's hilarious. That's not real.
That's none of these are real.
The Jessica Rabbit picture?
Yeah, I mean, those titties are. Her tits look like that. Maybe they do, though.
Die! Don't you understand?
They're still doing Roger Rabbit. Oh, my. That's real. You don't like that?
No, buddy.
She looks like a Viking queen.
You're missing my. I do like it. That particular picture, it looks like her boobs start in the middle of her fucking torso. It's weird.
Look at that.
Look at it. Look at it.
I mean, that is.
Oh, wait. That's her. That's her. The
what, yeah,
I've seen that picture. No, right. Right there. I've seen that picture before. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Oh, she doesn't.
Oh, she did. She has nude leaked. Nice. Fired up.
Don't you understand?
Gentlemen.
What?
I'm your gentleman's. Oh, yeah, that's her. Look at those big old titties.
Oh, take me to tit fuck heaven.
She's got very, very soft nips, though, like very soft colored areolas. Where it looks like it's just a tit with a nip growing out of it.
I love
like
it.
A little bump in the nip.
Look at her. I almost kicked you.
Buddy, I'm in. Oh, well, look at that technology. Yeah, all right, Cameron, yes, you might be right about that. She has to get a little more popular, maybe. Is that what it is? Or is she? Is she wildly popular?
She's pretty popular. Do you know who she's married to, actually? And this is going to kind of blow your mind. Remember Super Troopers, the opening scene where the kid has to eat all the drugs, the mushrooms and the weed and everything? She's married to that guy.
What?
Oh, that guy. He was in that movie Devil.
Yeah.
No one saw that movie?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah,
that's
I think she's still
good for him.
Yeah, really. Oh, that's not going to last forever.
I don't know, man. That could be true love.
Now, I bet they were both struggling actors trying to figure it out.
His name's Jeffrey Arend. Jeffrey fucking lucky as hell. fucking goes home smiling every evening.
I bet. I mean, he's not a bad looking guy necessarily, but I mean, like at all. But it's just like she's a head turner.
I mean, to be married, yeah, that's crazy. She looks, seriously, straight up looks like a Viking queen.
Yeah, there he is. Yeah.
Wow, good for you, Geoff.
Oh, he's fucking up for sure. But yeah, like, when you see a picture of them like, on a red carpet, though, I bet. Go, he looks fine.
Yeah.
Hey, you know what?
He looks like her butler.
Hey, you know what? No.
Miss, I've got the car around the corner. Miss, I actually, yes.
Hey, Faye. Hey. Wow, man.
What?
Good for him. You know
what?
Good for him.
Yeah.
All right, Cameron, you broke our hearts. You happy?
Thanks, dude. I'll tell you what. Why don't I give you the key to the apartment I'm staying in? You can come in the middle of the night and punch me in the throat.
You got us all lubed up, and then you punched us right in the cunt.
I get it. Thanks.
All right, Cameron, thanks for calling, buddy.
A lot. Cameron, you're a good dude. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for lashing.
Russ in Philly has a sentiment that I completely agree with.
Philadelphia.
Russ, Philadelphia Eagles coming up victorious. The season's about to turn around. Am I right?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Are you? It sounds like you're whispering into the phone, like you're hiding from somebody.
His parents keep him in a crate like veal.
Are you the goat from Pulp Fiction?
I walked away from the other room. I have somebody in one of the tanks.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I thought that sounded like you were like trying to get away. Who's your favorite hot older chick?
Gina Davis.
Yeah,
man.
I'm not on board with that.
I don't think she's good now.
This January.
But you didn't like a young Gina Davis?
Nope.
Really?
Too much teeth.
Oh,
League of Their Own.
A League of Their Own. I didn't like her. I didn't. I'll say it right now.
Thelma and Louise, man.
No, I was more into Sarandon.
Did you see in Thelma and Louise the scene when she's in bed with Brad Pitt? And by the way, I used to get, this how you know what a creepy kid I was. I used to get Celebrity Sleuth magazine, Celebrity Skin. What? They were magazines that had like the first new, but before the internet.
Them? How did you?
Before the internet.
Yeah, but where would you get them?
I'd steal them from the drugstore.
Oh, okay, cool.
Yeah, I was too young to purchase it.
Hello, I would like some Celebrity.
But the scene they, now they do is you'll find it, Christine, when I explain this to you. But there's a scene where it's just a close up, her when she's wearing panties, laying in bed, and it used to always describe, you know, those like celebrity porn magazine things, like her muff was so thick that you see like a big like bush up, like fills up. Like it fills her underwear up with beef. I love it.
And that got you?
I got no problem with that.
I'm not a fan.
Really?
Sorry, man.
Oh, I like it.
I thought so she was good.
Charlie sorry. Baltimore, remember when she was Long Kiss Goodnight? Nothing, huh?
Nope.
Just doesn't do it for you.
Nope.
You find her unattractive.
Did the mic just pick up me farting?
Is that what happened? You farted. I swear I thought Christine just turned in her chair or something. Man, these things are over-modulated. But let me try one. Do we get it? Do we get it?
Absolutely.
That's great.
No, man, I'm not a Gina Davis
fan. I'm not giving up on this yet.
No.
Bring her up in Transylvania 6500.
What? That sounds like you're giving shuttle launch instructions.
Yeah. And first of all, Transylvania spell with a Y. You are an
Wait,
idiot.
What are you... You think you're going to turn me?
Yes.
There's no way you're not... I'm sorry, man. Call this the Gina Davis theory. There's times where we... I mean, okay.
Yeah, see?
Okay.
Look who's back in the game. Look at that body.
All right. Yeah, but because they enhance her teeth by making her a vampire.
It would make sense if she was a vampire. So now you get
I'm
it more, now?
Yeah, I'm on board. My brain can wrap itself
around.
Yeah, it's
a Celebrity Sleuth.
Celebrity Sleuth. Yeah, I mean, she's very pretty. I'm not saying she's not pretty.
She's gawky. And she reads gawky, I feel like. You know what I mean? Like, you can tell she's like a tall... Look at how many times she was in that Celebrity Sleuth magazine.
That's
when
why.
When I was younger, yeah. This is a great story. I don't think I've ever told this. I went to... So my grandfather was sick. This is a piece of shit I am.
Okay.
My grandmother and grandfather had these friends. They were, you know, aunt and uncle, but they weren't aunt and uncle. You know,
yeah, friends of the family.
Aunt Anita and Uncle Herb. Uncle Herbie. And I went to stay at their house one night, and I found his stash of porn magazines, and he had a bunch of Celebrity Sleuths. So I took him into the bathroom with me, of course.
Absolutely.
When I brought him out, I was like, you know what? He's got a bunch. He's not going to notice a few missing. And if he does, he's not going to think it's me. And if he does, he's not. You can't go say, hey, give me back my porn magazines. Except that's exactly what he did.
Yeah.
It came down the pipeline from grandmom to my mom to my stepmom to me. How embarrassing. And I had to return them. I had to give them back.
First off.
Magazine.
That guy's way too committed to beating off to fucking those magazines.
Uncle Herb loves a good tug to a fucking young
Gina
Davis.
How old were you?
10?
No.
10, 11, 11
times. You gotta let that go.
What?
How embarrassed were you?
Dude, so embarrassed. Like crazy. Oh, yeah, they have those naked shots around the beach, but they're never good. That shows her in her natural gawky weirdness.
Sorry.
Her naked pictures. You don't have to apologize, buddy. It's okay.
I'm sorry.
And I don't think she aged great. But I mean, come on. Go back to that last one, the bikini.
Wasn't she in The Fly?
Yeah, and she was really, really pretty in The Fly. By the way, she's an attractive older woman. It's just like, I don't have that still like, holy shit, like she's hot thing anymore.
I'm amazed that they would embarrass you at 10 years old to give the porn back.
You think you just let me just eat it? Just take that. It was just three. It was like three of them.
My mom found my porn. You brought up Lorenzo Lamas earlier. Mm-hmm. His wife was in Playboy.
Shauna Sand. She has a sex tape, too.
And I had Anna Nicole Smith. I had a bunch of pictures, right? And I kept them under this box. Under the box. Not even in the box. Under the box on my top shelf of my closet. And I just knew I had to reach back, and I could feel the top of the paper. And then I'd pull it out, and I'd jerk off to it and put it back. And my mom found them and just threw them away. Didn't say anything.
That's classy.
I just went. I went to jerk off one day and it wasn't there, and I was like, "I know the score."
I got caught with my stash.
You got caught? Like she confronted you about it?
My brother ratted me out. Did I ever tell it on the show?
No.
We used to have all my friends come over, and like after school, and I'd be watching my brother buy a telescope box full of porn. I've never told this. No. If I have, it's pretty funny anyway.
I feel like you're an assassin when you would undo it.
Well, first we have to let Russ go. Russ, sorry, we're not going to get Dan to agree that Gina Davis is a hot chick.
Russ, I really appreciate you guys trying to get me it, but I can't go.
But the important thing, Russ, DeMarco Murray came alive. Am I right?
You're right, man.
Also, Russ, I know you're hiding from possible gunmen reports, but I'm going to be filming my special in Philadelphia December 3rd, so hopefully you can come out for that.
The bank is under siege.
Trocadero, baby.
Yeah, buddy.
Fuck yeah, dude. That's awesome. And Russ, you know, good buddy. You'll probably make a trip up to New York when I do mine at Webster Hall, right?
Dude, we're all in the same area, tri-state area.
Yeah, we're all doing tri-state area.
I was sitting in the front row when you were at Helium with a really gay, flowery shirt, and you refused to make fun of me because it was too easy.
Oh,
there you go, Jay.
That's like a challenge.
I know. Thanks for calling in, dude.
Okay.
Thank you, Russ.
You know what? Someone bring up Christine, grab the call screen again, because someone brought up.
Well, let me tell you about the porn thing before I jump on that, because my little brother, and we thought it was funny to show my brother and be like, big tits, huh? Look at those big tits. And then one day, when everyone was, and I put my telescope box up back in my closet, and but I had so many porn magazines because my buddy John worked at a drugstore.
So he could just grab them for you.
He just took them. Yeah, he would just take them.
And you had the magazines.
I was about magazines well beyond needing to. When I realized that laptop can go Wi-Fi and all that stuff, and I mean, all those things.
You were magazine to Wi-Fi?
I was magazine to Wi-Fi.
That's it. You know, that's insane.
Three packs,
right?
For $10. You get the $10 three pack.
You get like the Chubbers, and then
the middle would be. Yeah. Oh, I'd get like Score with those big fat tit chicks.
What about Club International?
No, I was never a fan of that. I would do a Cherry. I would do a High Society.
I love that you did all these magazines.
Celebrity Sleuth is my fave.
I would do. I was VHS.
Oh no, I did do that. But I'm talking about Bathroom Jerks.
Oh,
Bathroom Tugs.
I would save it.
Oh yeah, for the VHS.
Yeah,
I needed it more than that. I needed it more than VHS could provide me.
I was always into I was into B movies, jumping up to porn, like Shannon Tweed shit.
Oh, me too. I went through that whole phase. Remember, or Teresa Russell and Whore?
Yeah.
So we used to show my brother the thing and be like, big tits, big tits. And one day, my family, my step-pop, my mom, me, and my little brother, he's a baby.
Yeah. How old was he?
Three.
Jesus.
He goes, so I'm probably 14 or 15. You know?
Okay.
And she goes, we were watching a TV show and there was nudity in it. It was like some movie or something. And my brother goes, big tits, big tits. And I'm just kind of like, rapscallion over here.
Hey, mom, looks like you made a horny one. Yeah, huh?
Big tits, big tits. And my mom's like, what? And he's like, we always make fun of Lou. He like hound dogs her up to my room. And this box was so beaten up by being taken down and put back up. And it's overstuffed with I'm not exaggerating. 60 magazines.
Oh, that's great.
My mom just touches the magazine and it just rains pornography over her head.
Because it spilled over?
It spills. It just opens up. It just breaks and such. And I got in so much trouble. But they put it all in the box and put it downstairs in the basement.
Yeah.
And then I was like, you know, I wish I could. I should ask my mom. I should get my mom on the phone at some point and ask my mom, like, what was the thing? Because they eventually just said, like, they're in the basement. You know what I mean? They kind of gave it, like, told me, like, they're in the basement. Like, keep them out of anything. You know what I mean? Yeah. But I don't remember the conversation. In hindsight, I feel
did
like.
Did you go and get them?
My mom telling me. I kept them in the basement from then on out.
Oh, so you just go down. So every time you went to the basement, your parents knew exactly what you were doing. Like, Jay's going nuts. I'm not checking the water heater. I'm going to go jerk off.
Yeah. Can you go change the water? Yeah. Can you go change the laundry over from the washer to the dryer, please? Like, yeah, I'll see you guys in, like, 15 minutes. Yeah.
I'm going to go sit on the dryer while I jerk off.
Tumble low, tumble high.
I call it
tumble high.
Oh, dude, Austin in California, you got a great hot older one that I'm in. I don't even think she's hot as much as I'm in love with her. What's up, Austin?
One sec, guys. Hey, can you hear me?
Yeah. What's up, dude?
Yeah, I got Julia Louis-Dreyfus.
Yes,
I think she is amazing on a lot of levels. She's hard to beat.
I think she's getting a little bit of her face is getting very angly as she gets older.
I think she's aged better than...
She's aged very well.
90%.
Without a doubt, but I don't know if, like, sexier or
I think
or
she's gotten sexier. I think she's gotten hotter. If you watch Seinfeld, from season 1 to 4, she's cute, and then, like, 5 to 9, sexy. Like, Elaine
in Seinfeld, I think she's really pretty.
And it ramped up with my puberty perfectly. There's a movie where she gets banged... And by a blind guy. Dude, I remember being told about it at football practice. And this is before the internet. And then I went to Blockbuster to rent the movie. And I can't remember what the name of it is. But there's a sex scene with Julia Louis.
JLD gets boned by an old guy.
It's like, but it's like a com. It's not really a comedy, but it's like. What's that?
He plays that blind lawyer in Arrested Development. But that's not.
No, it wasn't Arrested Development. It was a movie. And she gets banged.
Deconstructing Harry?
Yes, Deconstructing Harry, 1997.
So look up that scene.
But it's like, yeah, I jerked off to this.
Wes? No, we're gonna get caught.
They're all by the lake, I can see everything.
Right there.
Oh.
I jerked off to that.
That's a good scene, though, yeah. Yeah, I like one of the good sex scenes, like kind of real and like dingy.
Yeah, see? Oh, and then see, oh, the blind lady, that's what it is.
Ooh. I will, just 1 minute, it's almost over.
Wow, that's a good scene.
Right?
Yeah. It's those pounds.
Yes.
By the way, that's if I filmed that scene, I would get a boner.
100%.
Or something like that.
100%.
I wouldn't get a, if I had to be like in like those little weird underwear to do a sex scene where it's like a nude sex scene or something like that, and I was under the covers, even with a hot chick, I wouldn't, because I'd be like, we look silly, this is kind of dumb. But just like if I had a good excuse to like bang my like junk like in my pants, I mean, you know, they're definitely wearing pants for real.
Yeah, but
against their butt like that, I would get it. I'd chub up on that for sure.
Yeah, I mean, that's a great... See, she starts doing the smacking thing. So I remember being told about this at football practice and chubbing up in my football pants. Being like, wait, there's a sex scene with Julia Louis-Dreyfus? And this guy that was on my football team, Brian, was like, yeah, it's in Deconstructing Harry, the Woody Allen. And I was like, I went to Blockbuster and rented it. My mom was like, I remember that night being so excited. My mom at like 8 o'clock was like, I'm going to bed. I'm like, I'm going to watch this Woody Allen movie. She's like, oh, you and your love of comedy. Beat off.
Yeah, but I like it. She's cute. I just think now she's like showing her age. That's all.
Okay. Well, why you got to shit on me? Just because I took the
Angela I'm
Davis?
Showing my age.
Bro, you want to get real with this, bro?
You want to get mad real?
You want to get mad real? Austin, thanks for calling in, dude. And you're absolutely right. JLD is smoking hot.
Laying it down.
And she's a billionaire.
Is she? Oh, yeah. She comes from like a rich family or something.
Super
right?
rich family. Yeah. We got to take another break.
Oh, last one.
Yeah, last break. We'll be right back. You're listening to The Bonfire.
And now back to The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
I rent cars from Enterprise.
Boom.
He could still be alive. It's The Bonfire. Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95.
He is alive. You ever go to Coachella?
I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. And that was the song when I quit my job waiting tables. That was the first song I put on in my earbuds as I walked out of the restaurant. I had my bag of shit out of the locker, and I put on Picture Me Rolling on the way back to Queens.
I never had that fucking, like, you know what? I'm fucking out of here and quitting a job ever.
I didn't quit. I did my 2 weeks. I did my time.
Right. I would just never go again. And they call me like, do you work here anymore? I'm like, I thought you guys would not have this weird conversation with
God,
me.
Oh, God. I don't care.
I thought I just didn't show up anymore, you guys would kind of get that. But I never had any kind of legit job. I never, by the time I moved to New York, which is where, you know, it's where you had your last job, trying to make it in comedy, I was doing enough of that black circuit to get a couple $100.
Okay.
And Carla.
Yeah.
Waitress at the comic strip.
Yeah.
And made some money. So I just never had to have that kind of, it was definitely times where I was like, I may have to go get a job.
Yeah, so
that's scary. And probably I should, but, or I should have. But I should. I should probably get a job tomorrow.
Yeah, I'm like, dude, what are you doing?
By the way, we're going to have to move the showtime around because I'm picking up shifts.
Roy, my manager, won't let me off for that shift.
Look, I know it's a Del Taco, but, you know, pays the bills.
But, dude, yeah, but I that was the greatest moment of my life was when I got the call from my manager on
Not
my
when
phone.
Your baby was born.
Not my son, Jacob, who I named after our producer.
Did you ever see, there's a great visual joke in I think it's a Family Guy episode or something, and it was like, happy bar mitzvah, Jacob, and then underneath it in parentheses it said, nice name, by the way.
That's great. But that was, my manager called me on my cell phone, and I mean, I was waiting, I was on the floor, and I went downstairs, and he's like, yeah, you can quit. He's like, you can quit your job. And really? I was like, I get to quit because I started working with Guinness. He was like, you can go quit. Go quit.
That's great.
That's what he did when he called me on the phone. He told me, it was like the call I've been waiting for 5 years. And I went up to my manager. I was like, I'm done. I'm done working here. And he's like, what? I was like, I'm done. Next Wednesday is going to be my last day. And then I left on that last Wednesday. I left, and that was when I was still heartbroken by that British rapper.
Which, by the way, we teased, did not talk about at all the other day. But let's save it. Let's save it for Wednesday.
Okay. All right. I've always wanted to tell that story about how I fell in love with the British rapper.
How can I stop you there? I thought we were going to talk about the hot daughters of these hot chicks.
We are. And that's what we're going to get to. So we'll preview that. And if someone tweets and reminds us, we'll talk about it on Wednesday. But I listened to Pox, Picture Me Rolling, as I went to the train from my last day of work. And it was great.
Buddy, just
and I just kept going, oh, manager shift at Dos Caminos. You still see me, right? Can you see me?
Can you host see me?
Can you see me getting a monthly pass on the Metro card and not sweating it?
Dan, I got to tell you, I can't let you bring it up at all, though. And walk away without just giving a little teaser again about when you dated the British rapper. It's one of my favorite things ever. I mean, I just squeezed my pee hole from pissing the first time you were telling me about this chick. Yeah, and she would, dude. Musicians, we talked about it with like the acoustic guitar people before and all that stuff. Like, they really like they believe in it so much. I've never thought like off of stage that it would be awesome to tell a girl or try to impress her with my
jokes,
like my actual material of what I'm doing. I'll recount something that happened that night or something like that, but I mean, I can't understand. But she just did it so willingly.
She would sing. She was also a singer, so she would like sing, and I'd be like, "Oh, that's great." But then she wouldn't do it in like.
You made her sound like fucking Pygmalion, though. No, like, everything was like, "Hello, Dad, we want me."
No, she didn't have a
beans and pork every night. No, beans and pork.
She had a regular British accent, but the whole thing is
porridge.
I like chimney sweeping and getting me coos filled by your picker.
No, that's not how it rolls. Well,
getting me coos.
Yeah,
getting me coos filled.
It wasn't that at all. She was actually like, she's gorgeous and she
gorgeous,
gorgeous, and she's talented. But she
is
would
she
rap.
Listening?
I don't know, but she would rap, and it would be like I went to one of her shows, and I was like, So I mean, fuck it, we'll just tell the whole story. I was hooking up with her, and I started really getting into her, and then. She picked another dude. She started like hooking up with another guy we worked with, and it bummed me out. And our good friend Nate Bargatze had to talk me off the cliff because I was super bummed out.
You went through it bad.
I was just sad, and I was opening for him, and we were driving to Maine. And I remember Nate going, "What'd you think was going to happen? What, were you going to marry her?" He's like, "Is that what's going to happen? Y'all going to get married and have kids, and then she'd be rapping while she puts away your laundry?" And we were doing that.
Soxin, boxin, roxin.
That was like the whole thing. Nate and I have done that for years to each other. And then we just joking around about her and I having a baby and her battle rapping the baby.
Because you can't even go without sucking me tit.
And I'm like, oh, damn. Yo, mom just burned your ass with those hot 16 bars.
Damn.
Oh. I mean, I'm in love with that accent. I love British women. And she was smoking hot.
Hey. Really? You like when Mel B talks?
Yeah. Oh. I don't like when she talks shit about our buddy Gary Veeder on America's Got Talent.
I don't like that accent at all.
I love it. You don't like it?
No. I love your penis. I love it. I don't know what she said, but she goes, I didn't know if you were going to be funny. And then I absolutely loved it.
I loved the way. Proper.
Oh, wow. She looked good in that picture.
Smoking.
Well, no, she porks up.
All right, bro.
Jesus.
Welcome to the Snatchers of London.
Wow, when did she pork up? She's fucking. Today she's like a fucking CrossFit model.
Yeah, today we look at pictures of Mel B. Completely in the nude. She's smoking hot.
No, that accent is
love
my
the accent.
I don't.
You don't.
Oh fuck! Oof!
You're making him sound like Game of Thrones character.
I'm nailing it. We gotta have some audio of her talking.
It's your booty.
I absolutely love it.
Man, I loved it.
There you go.
Oh,
there's that fat cow.
She went real Carmilla Bing.
Which is funny. No, she's just pregnant in that picture. Oh, okay. But that's what I'm saying. Insulting her. Oh, you big fat pig. Oh, who's that dude getting the rub?
He's wearing confident white sweatpants.
Oh, he sure.
So you don't like that accent at all?
No.
Fuck you, man.
I don't
fight you on At Midnight. Aaron Thursday, midnight on Comedy Central. Me, you, and Morgan Murphy.
Me, you, and Morgan Murph, hanging out.
Murph doll.
Killing it. And the only employee.
I don't think I want to
go back.
Go,
how about that?
Man.
Do you love her there, Dan?
Yeah.
You do?
Look at those tits.
Really?
Yeah.
You like her there?
Yeah.
You don't mean that.
I do mean it. Love her there.
Yes. Yeah, I liked when she was Scary Spice. When she was actually, when she had that frizzy hair, like the
wait, won't.
Yeah, yeah.
I really wrong.
I thought she was the hottest one.
I was, hardly enough was into.
Yeah, look at her. Now, I'm all about that. Yeah. Just come in, fuck all your friends, steal your Nintendo games.
Wow.
Yeah. I pictured the whole thing.
Yeah, you were really deep on the character description. Do you don't like,
I think her name is Scary Spice, but really every adult just called her the black one.
Yeah. I didn't like that she criticized Gary Veeder on America's Got Talent.
I think, what'd she say? Listen, you're very phony, but I don't love it.
I don't like it, Mr. Marini. Your jokes are confusing me. I don't like it.
I'm in here trying to eat me porridge.
You come down, me chingy.
It's all gross.
And then ye come up here. Trying to be, what are you, a phony guy?
Listen, if we're building Dan Soder a perfect woman, British accent, big boobs.
Really?
Get out of here.
Where do you fall on Lindsay Dawn McKenzie? Do you remember her?
No.
Lindsay Dawn McKenzie.
Do I? Why does that sound familiar?
She was all those big tit magazines. She only did one fuck scene where it was with her husband, I think.
Fuck. Dude, who was the girl?
And she was like, if
Lucy Pinder.
But she looks like she's just like full of booze, and she has that bubble like Jimmy Durante nose, but like something about her I liked.
No way. She looks like, remember the lady I told you about that I used to jerk off?
Yeah, but find good pictures of her. There you go.
Wait, do you remember the lady I used to jerk off to at Circle K? I told you about that?
Yes.
I jerked off to that lady at Circle K. That's what she looks like. That's what that lady at Circle K looked like.
So she's good.
She's got day manager face of a Circle K.
Sure. But I mean, it was good though.
Remember Lucy Pinder? Go to Lucy Pinder.
I do, but you don't like Lindsay Dawn McKenzie. I mean, yeah. Look,
I mean those. Yeah.
No. Let's get a close up of one of these. Come on now.
Jeez.
Come on.
Jesus.
Come on.
Her face looks too menacing.
Come on. She has a face. Come on. Come on.
Come on.
Come on.
No.
Yeah, man.
No, not into it. Go to Lucy Pinder.
I don't even know you, bro.
Yeah, bro.
LA's changed you, dude.
Yeah, I've gone Hollywood. I've got Hollywood. There she is. Look at her.
Yeah.
Oh, that's it?
She didn't do porn, though, right?
No.
Yeah.
She's classy.
Is that what it is?
She's British, too.
But where's she? What's she do? She's like one of those like page three chicks?
Yeah.
Page six? Oh, yeah. No, she's great. Yeah.
And she's got that accent.
Ugh. That's the worst part, though.
No, it's not.
Sure it is.
I think Boston accent's way worse than that.
No, dude, that's...
Would you rather fuck a chick with a Boston accent or an English accent?
Let me take off me knickers and underpants.
Fucking put your hard cock right in my...
No, that's the worst one for me.
Fine as fucking get your cock. Oh, fuck me. You a fucking hung kid. You got a fucking piece on
Wacky, you got a real hag on you, yeah?
You're fucking really digging me out of here.
I think I was blocked up. You broke through.
Oof. Oof. You are fucking me hotter than the NFL fucked Tom Brady before they reversed their suspension.
Oh, this fucking cack is badming me out.
Fucking talking my... You're touching my back there.
I'd much have a...
You're busting up my liver.
Yeah. We got to finish talking about hot older ladies. And someone that I wanted to bring up, Travis in California. I mean, this goes... Oh, my mic just broke.
Cackalack, Travis.
Hey, what's up?
What's up, dude?
What's up, dude?
So, how about Diane Lane?
100%. Way on board with Diane Lane. Cherry Valance from Outsiders?
Not anymore.
Dude, she still holds up.
Mm-hmm.
Her and Ashley Judd, man, they still hold up. Try to tell me they don't hold up?
Although, Christine saw her. She came in a stand-up long ago.
Yeah, because...
Christine, would you have described her as hot?
Okay, really pretty. But that's what happens in the older...
Does that work at all?
I'm
No, it doesn't
but
work.
You said she's really pretty.
She's really pretty. She's held up, and she's so tiny. She's super thin.
She's tiny.
That's a big thing, too. These girls, they're always, like, really small chicks. And they go back, wow, I can't believe we're about to fuck somebody over on that, talking about an older chick. She's not older than me. I'm 38 almost. But our night with Lisa Ann, someone was like, going to talk about that more. But I think, yeah, Diane Lane, like I said, seems really tiny. Like, when Lisa Ann walks up, you could almost think it's a kid. Like, she's tiny.
Yeah.
Everything about her is like super, super tiny. And we had a guy earlier who wanted to know more about the night. It wasn't, you know, didn't turn into a gangbang or anything. We hung out.
She's super cool.
We went to a concert, or before we went to a concert, we went to a bar.
She put my glasses on, which I immediately jerked off to when I got home.
Did you jerk off to her the night?
Yes.
It's one of the things I said, that's why I said the night. She did Legion of Skanks a week ago.
Yeah.
And I said that I was like, I bet everybody went home and jerked off to her porn that night, because she's very like, she's very like accessible, like talk to you. Like, you know,
she was very nice. She's very nice. She's funny.
Oh man, it's a shame when you're a hot chick like that. They really go out of their way to capture bad pictures of you, because
she had a great Curb Your Enthusiasm reference.
She's a beautiful girl.
Yeah. She's fun.
Yeah.
And then I went home and I jerked off to her porn, which I had been doing for over 10 years. So.
And you did that really? Like, you jerked off to her porn that night?
Yes.
You went home and knocked one out?
Yeah.
Were you smelling your glasses?
I had them on. I wore them.
I wonder. I have to. Well, I'm sure she has like several dudes. I don't think she has like a relationship necessarily. Like a long. Maybe she does. I don't know.
Who knows? We'll have to have her on when we're back in New York.
I wonder how many times she's been in love with a dude.
We got to find these things out. We'll have to have Lisa Ann on the bonfire.
Yeah. Why wouldn't we?
And then she can put my glasses on again, so I can go home and jerk off to him.
Hey, can you put on my underwear,
dude? I was laughing so hard. When you and I were outside of Radio City, we were actually talking about this exact thing. We were talking about jerking off to Lisa Ann, and we were joking around about, because you gave me her number, and her and I had text, and I said reading her texts as I jerk off with my glasses on, listening to War on Drugs, listening to War on Drugs with Red Eye playing in the back. Lou, if you're there, cue up Red Eye from War on Drugs.
Red Eyes.
You're Red Eyes. You want to fight, dog?
Totally. We should go back to the call page. Now I'm feeling too mellow with this War on Drugs. Someone's got to get me boned up. Travis, good call on Diane Lane. I did enjoy the scene in
Unfaithful.
Yeah, that was pretty good. A similar thing to that Julia Louis-Dreyfus thing.
Absolutely. Where it was like, realistic bumping.
Yeah. Also, anything... There was a Toxic Avenger scene. It was about... Something terrible was about to happen, but it didn't... She got saved, but there's a scene... Anything where it's like lifting a skirt and pulling down pants.
Yes.
Or pulling down pants and just getting like that... It doesn't have to be anything graphic. A side-ass view of pants being pulled down the fuck.
Can I bring back an old bit from our friendship?
Love it. Yes.
Remember the one-arm fuck against the wall? When you pull the panties down? Remember that? That's from like 7 years ago.
Give up.
Yeah.
Give up.
Jay and I used to do against the wall, pulling down panties with one hand.
And then pulling your own dick out.
And then going...
Yeah. You got to curl it up on it. Get underneath. Yeah.
Remember we used to do that against the wall?
Get it.
We used to do it against the wall of Eastville.
Just gotta get him in. Yeah.
In and mass. No way. Also, again, we gotta plug it one more time. Jay and I are gonna be on At Midnight this Thursday on Comedy Central at midnight with Morgan Murphy, the hilarious Morgan Murphy.
Hells, yeah. Well, Christine took it upon herself to go to the scene she likes to jerk off to that has a similar thing. I assume that's what this is.
Yeah.
But yeah.
This wasn't realistic to me because they're both standing up having sex standing. That's unrealistic to
me. Yeah, she's...
Oh, never mind. Good for you, Marshall Mathers. We're watching the sex scene in 8 Mile with Brittany Murphy and Eminem. R.I.P.
I think I like to see more when she's getting just dicked down by the black dudes in the studio later.
Is that was the part that you liked?
Yeah. And she got caught, and she's over the shoulder. She's like, oh. She goes, I know people can see, but I don't want him to see.
She just clears him out. Yeah.
When I'm done.
Pat in Ohio.
What's up?
Hey, buddy. Who's your hot older lady?
Christy Brinkley, dude.
Still to this day.
She holding up?
Fuck yeah, I mean, dude. Look her up.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to offend you.
Suck my dick, bro. Yes.
Yeah. That's that Billy Joel fucking scene. Oh,
that's what it was all written about. 61 years old.
Wow. She does hold up.
Yeah. Yeah. Wow. She's 61?
Yep.
What do you think it shows? It's got to show somewhere. You think it's just like a crazy knot, like between her pussy and asshole, where she just constantly twists it?
Like a balloon? Like it's got the yeah. little.
And every once in a while. Every,
whoa!
Every once in a while, she has to just twist it and it pulls everything
that's
together.
She goes to a surgeon in Portugal that just twists it around. Go. I mean, that's she's 61.
Well, Ryan, you might be the winner, buddy.
Yeah, dude. She looks like a senator's wife.
Or Pat, I'm sorry. Pat in Ohio. That's. Wow. Go back to that thing that says, like, sexy at 60.
Well, you guys are all
Wait, what?
You're all staticky.
You're all staticky.
Oh, sorry. We were cricking up some Uptown Girl.
Yeah, sorry. We were playing Uptown Girl and both chubbing up over Christy Brinkley.
She looks amazing. God damn.
That's crazy. Good call. Pat in Ohio with the win.
She's never done nudity, huh?
No way, man.
She's married to that lawn gnome for so many years.
Yeah, piano slamming.
I mean, he was winning, huh?
Yeah.
She may look better than those young girls he gets.
Now?
I don't know. He may be married again now, but even like he's married like younger girls a couple times, I think.
He's not topping that.
I might take her at 60 over...
She looks fantastic.
Christine. I'm going to dump Christine for this girl.
Christine, I don't think he's going to do that. Don't do that. If you could, keep operating the...
I need a mature woman. Christine's a girl.
I need a lady.
I need a 60-year-old to help me fucking... Blue plate special.
She's like, do you want to know?
I want to get the early bird.
Do you want half of my Centurum vitamin?
We're fucking at 7. We're asleep by 8.
Yeah. If anything, I'm relaxing by 8:45. She's up at 9. There's a problem.
That's great. I pound her out, then I rub Icy Hot on her joints.
And then I have a cool glass of iced tea to unwind.
It's sun tea. She makes it.
In between calls to her grandchildren.
She has a recipe from the old country. That's good. Good call, Pat. Thanks for calling, buddy.
Thanks for calling, buddy. Sorry we were staticky. We didn't mean to be shady towards you. Yeah.
I did. I meant to be.
Hey.
We did this actually during the break, but Donald from North Cackalack.
Hey, what's going on?
Trying to hear through these phone calls. What's up, my friend?
All right, so before I get to it, I got to say the only way I can sleep at night is Mad Men Girl, her husband from Super Trooper. He's got to have a hog or something like that. That guy's got to be just hog.
Oh, that's the
only
way I can sleep at
night. What's his name? Let's look up his name again and see.
Geoff, Jeff,
whatever
lucky,
it is, and then
guy.
Google that name, and then with the word big dick, and let's see if anything comes up.
All right. It's a little Google investigation. He's probably just got like a fucking cookie dough roll.
That's, by the way, there's a the first thing, if you look that up, it says he must have a huge dick.
Yeah. Jeffrey Arnett says must be hung like a moose.
He must be hung like a moose. I mean, yeah, that blows it. Man, that's got to be a tough thing for him to like swallow.
Yeah, walk around with.
Because like every time you see it, I mean, it looks like he's winning, but you always have to still wonder. When she like, I got to go do a movie for 3 months on the road. You're like, oh man, she's constantly being told.
Yeah, he's just got to
publicly like, what's this dude's deal? Because, or a bit, sometimes that guy is crazy confident. I wonder if Billy Joel walked around going like, or was he like, I'm Billy Joel. Where's this goofy bitch going?
See, that's the thing. It says he's probably like, I'm Billy fucking Joel. I'm the Pierre. Looks around.
But then again, when you're with somebody with any kind of regularity, that guy's seen Christina Hendricks at her worst, sick,
yeah,
leaving shit streaks on the bowl from a big turd that didn't clear, that breached the water.
Hold my hand while I poop.
Because I'm pooping.
Yeah, but Donald, you got a good point. I he's got to have a fucking monster dick, dude.
I agree. Yeah.
But getting to the point that I called for, you got to check out Susan Sarandon's daughter. I can't believe you guys haven't talked about this.
Yeah, we just did, and because we saw your call.
We're still
the clip
we
with
still
the landlord.
The landlord. Christine's all about tabs when she does computer work.
Yeah, but Susan Sarandon's daughter, Ava?
Eva Amuri? What's that name about?
Is that Tim Robbins? Is that her daughter with Tim Robbins?
Yeah, I think so.
Howard the Dick.
Yeah, she's
pretty hot.
She's crazy hot.
There's shots where she's
Californication.
Oh, is she in that?
Yeah, she shows it all too.
Oh,
shows it all. What?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Holy shit! Yeah,
she does show it all.
Ooh. Good Lord.
Good job, David Duchovny.
Oh, good job, Tim Robbins, man.
Why?
That guy's jizz has great tits in it.
It's an element of his jizz.
It's Tim Robbins' jizz. It's got big tits in it. That's how you know it's real.
Dad's got the best jizz.
Oh, it's got such big tits in it.
I'm going to start complimenting girls in their father's jizz.
Ooh, good jizz from
your dad. Oh, my God, that's a great ass. Your dad has great jizz.
Yeah. I think we covered the entire spectrum. Donald, thanks for calling in.
Yeah, thanks.
And sorry we couldn't.
It's almost Cypress Hill time.
I know. Too bad we couldn't find out if that dude Jeff's got to
roll it up, light it up, smoke it up legally.
We got more time out here on the West Coast. We got Wednesday.
Oh yeah,
Wednesday we're gonna be live.
We're doing a little Wednesday.
6 p.m. Eastern. Oh, wait, 3 p.m. Pacific.
Christine, go back to the call page. For the people we didn't get to, so I want to make sure they get in there. Barbara Eden, hot older chick. Not sure. She was a hot young chick as Jeannie.
Yeah, true.
I Dream of Jeannie.
Thanks, Ryan.
Renee Russo, I always thought was a frog-eyed pig.
All right. So, Raven in Miami.
I'm going to try to keep a straight face. She was a hot young chick. She was hot. Yeah. But even like, she always had, yeah, that's that square fucking.
Yeah.
That fucking Terminator head.
And then Chapman in Houston, Monica Bellucci, absolutely.
Monica Bellucci, mega hot. One of the most conflicted jerks you could ever possibly have.
Why?
That movie Irreversible.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's a horrific rape scene, but it's another one of those panties get pulled down thing, and you're like, and you know it's a movie. Had a lot in common. We've covered this, but it is true. The reason you can still bone up to movie rape sometimes.
You know they said cut.
You're not a piece of garbage. This is for the people out there. This is my public service. You're not a piece of garbage if you've happened to bone up during a rape scene. It's a movie. And you know that. You know that going in.
My Irishness will not let me let go of that guilt. And I couldn't.
However, means you're a closet rape jerker. It means you fucking really enjoy the...
No!
We'll catch you next time on the bonfire.
But,
Dan loves rape. We'll catch
no,
you next time on the bonfire.
No. At Big J. Okerson. That's funny. Good job, Lou. At Big J. Okerson on Twitter. At Dan Soder on Twitter. I'm going to be opening for Nick DiPaolo this Saturday, Gramercy Theater. Go get tickets.
And I will be tomorrow night, Mountain View, Oddball. I'll be hosting the festival stage.
Yes.
Small stage. Hosted last night in Irvine, the main stage I hosted, too. Unbelievable.
That's great.
Fucking unbelievable show.
Make sure you go check it out.
Such a blast. And then next weekend, all the Texas states, Oddball. And then that tour is over, my friend. That is it. We have Houston, Austin, and Dallas next weekend. And then I come back, and then Halloween weekend, I'll be in Buffalo. Weekend after that, back in San Fran at the Punchline. So, this has been fun, dude. We'll catch you guys Wednesday
for more West Coast Bonfire.
B-Fi.